As a medical school applicant, one of the most difficult decisions you may face is how to handle a waitlist decision from a school you really want to attend. The decision can be difficult as you decide whether to flood your school with additional material, hoping it's something you send will convince the admissions team to admit you, or if you should just sit tight and not risk annoying the admissions committee with unsolicited material. Our best advice is to simply follow the instructions from the admissions committee. If they prefer you not send in additional material, then you should honor their policy. Even though it can be tempting to let them know how interested you are, disregarding their request may put you at a disadvantage. While you want to remain in contact with your school while on the wait list, you need to be careful not to overstep the boundaries. Sending an additional 10 letters of recommendation may convince the admissions team you are well qualified to attend. It may also make them question what kind of student you will be once you arrive on their campus. We always encourage applicants to remain positive when they are placed on a wait list. Many applicants who are placed on a wait list and are not accepted opt to reapply to that school the following year. Candidates who are considered during the application process one year will be thought of more positively the next. The way you present yourself as a potential med student is something important to remember, especially if there is a chance you may reapply to that school later. If you do submit a letter of continued interest, instead of a generic letter, a specific approach is far more convincing. Tell the admissions committee reasons why you want to attend this school and how this specific school would be a good fit, highlighting anything that is new and different to your application since you completed your original application. Schools use waitlists to control class size. Admission is not an exact science, but schools have a certain number in mind of how many students they want to enroll. If too few students accept offers of admission, admissions committees will consult the waitlist, review the applications, and consider admitting one. The list is typically not ranked, but it can be used to balance or solidify certain aspects of the class demographics, like gender balance, diversity numbers, geographic distribution, or to make sure the financial aid budget can be met. So, if someone with a similar background to yours denies an offer, you are more likely to be admitted. The wait lists at many medical schools are often large, and only a few students on the list are expected to be admitted. In addition, wait lists are often used to craft the class later in the admissions cycle. By May or June, admissions offices have a good idea of what the class looks like. Some candidates on a wait list may hear their fate quickly, as some schools review their wait lists after first deposits are due around April or May. Elite schools have a policy to eliminate wait lists by early to mid-July, but other schools keep them longer and may not let students know they've been admitted until a few weeks before classes start. It's a good idea to determine how long you're willing to wait. Set a date. If you haven't been admitted by then, call and ask to be removed from the wait list. Either way, you will want to pay your deposit to enroll at a medical college by the candidate's reply date, May 15, just to be sure you have a spot somewhere. Remember, you will be expected to forfeit any deposit if you are offered a spot off the wait list at your top choice school. Being placed on a wait list certainly causes anxiety, but try to be patient. That particular medical school obviously saw strengths in your application, and they want time to reevaluate it. Staying positive is key, as med schools almost always accept people from a wait list later in the process. Remember, you are still in the game.
Whether you're planning to apply late or early in the admissions season, or just want to discuss some pre-positioning issues, we're here to help. Call us at 1-800-809-0800 to learn more about how we can ensure you maximize your medical school admissions chances.